It is currently 5 minutes after 11 o'clock. It is 107.7. My name is Rennie Bishop. Sunday morning. It's good to have you here. Sunday, May 29th. And there is a rush that came through the room. My two guests brought clarity with them. But there is a celebrity in the house. A celebrity who has been across all over the world. I mean, you know, you just don't know where to start with him. But when you talk about the Strike Squad, you know who I'm talking about. Those are for the newbies. The older folks would understand the champion that played all over the place, from Cosmos to wherever you can find football, Mexico, everywhere he's been out there. He is Gally Cummings, Everald Gally Cummings. Mr. Cummings, sir, thank you so much. Good to see you.
Good to see you too, Eddie.
How is everything doing, man?
Everything is fine.
You look younger and younger every time I see you, so something is going on that I need to find out about.
Eat the right way, sleep when it's necessary.
Is that what it is?
And exercise when it's necessary.
Sleep when it's necessary. the only footballer today to have won the prestigious Sportsman of the Year Award 1974, Individual of the Year Award 1990, and two national awards in 1974 and 1989. He has passed through a lot of football history. He is a lot of football history. Nothing in Trinidad and Tobago in this area is spoken of without his name being in there. In addition to that, he came back and he said, I'm going to take your Strike Squad and I'm going to carry them forward. They went really, really close. And just one goal, huh? A game with one goal. And that is what denied you the chance, right? All right. But here's what's happening now. Everald Gally Cummings has said, I have done my football days. I'm open to anything you all want to do, but I want to do something different. I want to do some giving back. It is the giving back is why we are happy that you're joining us this morning. It's called the Gally Football Finishing School. What is that? Let us start from the beginning. 2002 is the first time you went about this. Tell us about it.
Well, yeah, in 2002, I was living in New York, mm-hmm. and I was coaching a lot of white kids in upscale New York. Mm-hmm. And I decided to have a joint venture where I can bring them to Trinidad, about 14 of them, and have them join up with our young footballers here so they could get to understand the culture
of Trinidad,
Trinidad and Tobago, mm-hmm. and how we do things, the mm-hmm. calypso, the steel band, the tasso, what you name it, you know. And they came down here. We spent 2 weeks. They stayed at Cascade at yes. Halicunia Guest House, and mm-hmm. we used the president's ground as a home field, and every morning I will have them around the Queen's Park Savannah, mm-hmm. and then we get into technical training and what have you. And they enjoyed it so much that we wanted to make another trip. But it was supposed to be so. After time and time and time, I've been looking at Trinidad and Tobago football, and mm-hmm. I noticed from my day up the Strike Squad and beyond, we are not creative, we're not scoring goals, and not only that, we play like other people.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We play a sort of unidentifiable football.
That is so important, yes.
And, mm-hmm. and when you grow up in the game, because I've been with the national team since 1965. I was about 16 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been with the team ever since.
And his powers actually started at 9 years old, but we'll get there in a minute. Let's continue on the 16 part, yeah. Yes.
And then, a lot of people in this society have been saying, boy, Gally, why don't you do your own thing? Because, you see, I have been having little problems here and there with the administration because they didn't know what they were doing. And I had to coach a team, manage a team, you know, be the historian to the team,
mm-hmm.
because the people in administration, you know, they were just there. I think maybe they had their own agenda, as we can quite rightly see now.
Mm-hmm.
But the Gally's Football Finishing School basically is the purpose is of this academy is to develop an elite group of well trained players
mm-hmm.
with the identity, you know, and a nice target group, target age group, giving them the opportunity to fulfill their social, psychological, emotional, and physiological needs. This football finishing school mm-hmm. will also help assist in reestablishing our indigenous way of playing football with the proper techniques, skills, tactics, organizational structure, you name it, enthusiasm, commitment, motivation, discipline, fair play, self-pride and national pride. The meaning of the word finishing school is to focus on helping youths defy delinquency and antisocial behavior and develop positive attitudes and behavioral characteristics while promoting order and discipline in life.
And that is the this is the important part that we need right now. I still want to, and we're going to get into details on that, because that is the aim at a time where the streets are saying to children, come quickly, we've got a fast way for you to do everything, and you don't have to be disciplined, and you don't have to do that. So this is very timely. What happened between, before we go deep into that, between 2002 and 15 years later, which is now, you had this plan, and for some reason, folks were not listening. Well, you said that they probably have their own agenda, or maybe it could just be ignorance, not having the experience or the knowledge of an inductee that was in 1989 into the Sports Hall of Fame in Trinidad and Tobago. That is my guest, Gally Cummings. The idea of setting up a school for kids nine, importantly, and like I said before, that's where you started. Yeah. At the time, your prowess started to come to the fore. But between nine and 16, that is a very, very formative age. And that's where, if you get them in there early, you start making a difference before they hit the streets.
Yeah. This is the age where you want to encourage them, you know, these young players, to understand the critical role that sports play in improving their lives, and the power of sport to build self-esteem, leadership skills, community spirit, and bridges and gaps across ethnic and communal divides. Mm-hmm. It's so many different things. And also, what I also try to instill in them is they must see problems not as insurmountable obstacles, mm-hmm. but as challenges to be met and conquered. You know, so many of our young people, you know, they give up because they don't feel there's no one out there for them.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
see,
mm-hmm.
When I coach, mm-hmm. I want them to know I'm there for them. You understand? And because the coaches that I'm going to have around me,
mm-hmm.
Most of them are all members of the strike squad from 1989.
I got you.
But we have a lot of them coaching under 20 teams, under 17 teams. Some of them are assistant coaches to the senior national team. And all these guys are going to come in and give their 2 cents in the program.
Yes.
Because I want to make sure that anyone that's going to be involved in the program must have a story to tell.
Like when
I was with the national team, this happened. So I need national team, you know, background from the players, and also, you know, they must be qualified, but they must have a national team background.
And they must have an understanding of what they're dealing with. When I asked you to go back to 2002, was for a reason. You yourself said you had folks from a different suasion, folks mm-hmm. from New York and Manhattan coming.
Yeah.
They could have afforded to, one, be involved in a program like that, and because of their openness to the rest of the world, let me just put it as gently as I can, they understood the importance of this. How are you going to attract parents here? How are you going to attract communities to get involved with this that you're doing? Because the question does come up. There are a lot of areas that we need to reach to bring at-risk youths involved in a program like this. The problem is, how do you get them to come to you?
Well, what I've been doing...
you to reach them.
Well, I've been trying to reach them. What I've been doing so far, I've been getting in touch with all the secondary schools and primary schools throughout Trinidad and Tobago. I think I've gotten in touch with over 50 coaches and teachers who have been in contact with the principals to let them understand the importance of this program.
You
see, I know there are a lot of people out there with coaching academies and stuff, but this is a specialized camp. We did it in finishing, creating and finishing the play. But as you know, the word finishing is not only about football.
That's right.
It's about a finished product of the person, a wrongdead person.
Yes.
So this is what it's all about. Because I'm tired every day, you look at the news, see the young people. Either some kind of problem going on at the same age that I can be helping. So I decided, you know, let me get involved. And this football finishing school has been long in coming.
Mm-hmm.
But from among the people in the country that keep saying to me, Gally, start something, get something, you know, our youngsters are going astray. So there is a need for it.
Yes, indeed.
But as I said, I hope the people who've been asking me to get involved, they will also get involved by getting the youngsters there, the kids, because it's about boys and girls, eh? It's both sides of the equation, boys and girls.
Mm-hmm. 15 minutes after 11 o'clock, we're talking to Hall of Famer. We are talking to international star. We're talking about the coach of the national team, the strike squad. We are talking about the man called Gally Cummings. You have chosen not to do this for money. You have chosen to set up an NGO instead. This is all about giving back.
But this is a non-profit organization. Mm-hmm. And as I said, is that, we really want to see if we can capture some of the sponsors, mm-hmm. you know, because so far we have some sponsors on board. We have Kiss, Bacon.
Mm-hmm.
I think they're the main sponsors right
Kiss.
Now.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We have Blue Waters, Gatorade, and Trotters Restaurant on Maravada Road.
I'm comfortable that a lot of people, and we will continue to carry the message, a lot of people will jump on this national brand. Everald Gally Cummings is the brand. That's easily recognizable. The intent is very clear. Your expertise is not in question. And the need to have our young folks involved in this means that you must have all the necessary tools, equipment, and so on to work. This must be a costly project. Without asking you for dollars and cents, this is a costly project.
It is a costly project because you don't know, one day we might have 200 kids.
Mm-hmm.
and we can't just turn them away.
So I've got my kid, and I hear that Mr. Cummings is involved in this, and the next thing I want to do is get him signed up in this. How long is it a period? How does it operate? Give me the details.
We have our website.
Mm-hmm.
You go into the website.
They can go
and
there
you download the registration
mm-hmm.
form.
Mm-hmm.
You fill it out. And since it's a sort of moving like a caravan, we started St. Mary's Grounds on the 11th of July.
Mm-hmm.
And the program is from 8 to 11 in the mornings. And then we do 10 sessions, so it's 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And then we go to Lunch Park, Chaguanas.
Mm-hmm.
And from there, we go to Eddie Hart Savannah.
That's yes, Tagarigua.
Yeah, Tagarigua.
Mm-hmm.
And from there, we go to San Fernando, in which we yet to have the venue verified, but the last area which might be going is Tobago. We have already sent documents over there to the representative of sport at the House of Assembly, and we're waiting for some feedback from them.
Mm-hmm. Just that I have folks very clear as to what we're talking about. We're talking about the finishing school. We're talking about the Gally Football Finishing School, GFFS. And folks who are desirous of getting more information can, one, check your Facebook. This is Facebook / Gally SFFS. And they can go up there and get more information. Or they can email you mm-hmm. at gallysffs@gmail.com.
There's also a phone number on there. If they want to to get some more information.
All right, I'll pull up that telephone number and I'll get it to folks before. You said you spent some time talking to some folks in government. I know you're an NGO. I know that you're looking for corporate sponsors to step in here, but clearly because of the dire needs of the nation in corralling and harnessing the talent of our youngsters and putting a stop to the only alternative, or one of the only alternatives, being gangs. The line ministry, have you had conversations with them at all, or have they had conversations?
Well,
with
we
them?
Have had some conversation, and we're waiting for feedback from them.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, Rennie, just getting back to where you talk about what you spoke about. I remember a young boy living with my grandmother on Nelson Street in Port of Spain. The Rye River.
Mm-hmm.
Was our playing field.
East Dry River, yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
No, I look in the Dry River and I see people squatting there.
Oh.
And old cars and old trees and stuff. That used to take all the stress away from young people in those days. But what I must say, some of the best footballers in Port of Spain came out from Lavendale. Lavendale had something like about 4 football teams.
Hello. Mm-hmm.
I remember that playing community football against.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to go up there and play ball, and you know, against guys up there.
Mm-hmm. I'm trying to remember the Dry River at that time. At least the water was just down center, and you could always play in the thing. Now they've got so much debris inside of it.
They always had that little water line in the middle.
This side against
you know, yes, and we used to use that for dribble.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
we had guys like falling in the water and all this kind of stuff. You know. But the thing about it is that we had fun. Our parents knew where we were.
Yes.
And then I started living on Dundonald Street.